Hi everyone, welcome to this last video. It's time to wrap up with take-home messages. So let's go there. Okay, how are we going now to tackle all these problems that we have to face in terms of image processing when we will be interested in plant phenotyping? So, what you have to take in mind, what are the take-home messages? So, first we have seen that there was an analogy and a similarity of image processing with analytical chemistry, meaning that you have pipelines of process that you put sequentially, each after each. And the idea is to first extract the compound, the informational compound, the information which is included in the image, and to filter it in many ways. So this is this convolution operation that we have seen. We will throw away what we don't want, so this is denoising, extract what we want. This is the highlighting of the edges or highlighting of some regions, and then quantify and characterize the amount of what we have extracted. So when it's fully automated in industrial mode, it takes the form of pipeline in chemistry, and that's also the word that we have for image processing. We have seen there was low-level image processing, mainly for denoising, that we can visit by going to in imaging in process filters mean or process filters median if you have spurious noise. You can also denoise by going to process FFT bandpass filter and set the size of the filter according to the structure of interacts you want to preserve. We have then seen middle-level image processing part where we like to enhance the structure of interest and afterwards some morphomathematics filtering. So enhancing the edges by process fine edges. We have seen it was high sensitivity, it had a high sensitivity to noise. So it's important to denoise first. Then for enhancing region, we have this in process filter with mean, variance, mid, max, according to what is invariant in the region of interest you want to highlight, enhance. After this, you can binarize your image by image at the threshold, and you will have access to the connected components, to the different particles that you can analyze. If there is a remaining noise, then you can remove it by erosion, dilatation, opening, and closure via the menu process binary. At the high level, you can count, do some measurement, or do some classification. Measurement is accessible in analyze set measurement, then analyze particle. And you can use the result in statistical analysis software such as R, or even do some Excel if you want to stay on simple softwares. Do not forget to firstly observe the image to set up parameters used to extract the information. So the filter size, the choice of enhancements, either we have edges or region. It requires to have a quantitative idea of the content of the image so that some tools are useful to observe quantitatively in images. So histogram, plot profile, calibration, set scale that we have seen during the course. As a last example of illustration, imagine we have this image. We will first make a profile and we want to count, for instance, the number of cells. We will first drag and drop a plot profile to see how strong the contrast is. So we move to 200 in the background to something like 10 or in the cell, so there is a strong background. If we do a global histogram, we see that we have two modes in the histogram, so the image is well contrasted. So the typical size of a cell is also given by the size here. It's something like 10 pixels of a diameter. So there is also some noise. We can also estimate if this noise is Gaussian, and indeed it seems like a yes, symmetric and Gaussianly distributed. So averaging by some mean would be a good option. When we do to reduce the noise, so when we do this to reduce the noise, we have to take care of the size of the filter since the cell is of a size of a 10. If we take a filter which is larger, So ImageJet, which is larger than the object itself, it will completely blur the image. So we don't have to tune this completely manually. We can beforehand think that if we have something which measures something like a 20 pixel, maybe maximum size of a ImageJet will be 2x2 or 3x3. And indeed, this gives rather good results, as we can see in here on the upper right. When we are here after denoising, either we use simply a threshold to enhance some region, the blobs by contrast with the background. We can also find edges and then fill holes, and everything will be somehow very similar to what we have by just the first threshold, if we accept objects which are touching the boundary, which cannot be filled as an object. And then the high level processing, counting and morphometric characterization is really just analyze particles. So it's really one click, and it's pretty easy to finish this way. So if you are facing a new image processing problem, you are not an expert in image processing, which is still your case even after this course, you can test these simple ideas of the take-home message number one. And we have seen that on more advanced problems, maybe it could be useful to use the random forest classification with Weka, which is a little bit more greedy in terms of computational cost, but which can solve maybe in an easier way if you are not fully confident with solving the problem with the method I've presented you. And if it fails, then maybe it's good then to call an expert to help you, because you might be faced to indeed a difficult problem. So thank you for your attention and watching this this video, and see you in the next activities.